Good morning, children. Praise the Lord, we meet again today. Stay healthy and happy on this new day. Now, get ready to start your day with new inspiring experiences taken from the book God and Me, written by Charles Mills. Children, are you ready for adventure and fun? Well, you've come to the right place, because this adventure is overflowing with stories and fun things to do. Every day, you will meet different boys and girls. They promise to be the loving and kind children that Jesus wants them to be. You can also share each of these stories with your friends. You and your friends will get to know your God who loves you so much. Now is your time to enjoy God's word through the adventure of this new day with the title, Jesus Buddy. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 26. It says, "For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." Is that real blood? I whispered to my uncle Sid. "Where?" he gasped. "Did someone get hurt?" "No." "There, in your glass. The preacher said that the grape juice was Jesus' blood, and that the bread was His body." "Oh," Uncle Sid said. Then he leaned down and whispered in my ear, "It's not real blood. It's supposed to remind us that Jesus died on the cross. He bled and died so we could live forever with Him in heaven." So I said thoughtfully, when they pass out those little glasses of juice and pieces of bread, we're supposed to remember what happened. That's right. The preacher said Jesus had a last meal with His disciples. They drank juice and ate bread. Today, we have this very small meal to remind us of that night long ago. I looked at the bread and juice. Then I remembered the story of the Lord's Supper. How sad Jesus must have been to know that this was the last meal He would enjoy with His friends. That night, I made another page in my Love God and God Loves Me book. In careful letters, I wrote, "Jesus loves me so much that He died for me." The juice and the bread helped me to remember that. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, get ready for a new adventure today. We're going to take our minds together to remember what was the most beautiful or best thing we've ever experienced. Maybe it was a kindness, a gift, or a memory that sticks in your mind. And of course, you will remember the person who gave you that wonderful opportunity. Children, today we will remember an extraordinary kindness, a sacrifice, as the best gift for you, me, and all of us. Think for a moment when Jesus had to die on the cross to atone for our sins. He gave himself, even died on the cross to save us. All of that as a sign of his love for us. Now we just need to always remember his sacrifice through the Holy Communion ceremony. Have you ever seen it? There is bread that symbolizes the body of Jesus. There is wine that symbolizes his blood. All of that is to remind us of his love and sacrifice. Children, today, think about this sentence, that Jesus loves me so much that he was willing to die for me on the cross. Children, pray, ask Jesus to help you appreciate his sacrifice and express your love for him through your obedience. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.